All right, what we want to do here is a little tale of some vector stuff. Sorry for the high-tech terminology. If you watch the some of the getting started videos that I suggested directly from the authors of MATLAB, the MathWorks, as I posted them in what's that thing called, Edmodo. Then you already have found out that you can create comment lines by using the percent symbol. And so we just want to do some stuff with vectors, because that's primarily the way that MATLAB works. And so I entered that vector, notice square brackets, some spaces. You could also put commas between them, but why bother with commas? It looks a little bit cleaner this way. And so that's a vector, one-dimensional vector. If we have multiple rows to go with multiple columns, then those become arrays, and those are what we'll get to shortly. But for this video, we're just going to deal with vectors. Now, there's some things that we can do to vectors. For instance, I can add something to the vector, each element of the vector that way. But notice that A still remains what it originally was. So what I can do is I can assign a value, create a new variable called b, and add 3 to it, and now I have a vector called b. And what if I wanted to multiply the vectors? Well, normally you would type this. This will produce an error because the inner dimensions don't agree. So if you took pre-calculus or even a little bit of college algebra, you know that they have to have inner dimensions equal to each other. So there is a way to element by element multiply and do exponents as well, and it's called, you use the dot multiply version, and lo and behold, you get A times B. But notice that A and B are still what they used to be, so we'd have to do what we had done previously to get that to change. Now I'm gonna clear my screen here, and A with 3 in parentheses. This is called indexing a vector, and what it'll do is it should return the third element of A. Let's look at what A was. 1, 2, 3. Yep, 3 was the third element of A. Now I can also say I want to change the value. Let A of 3 equal 222. There you go. I could also remove that altogether by simply filling that spot with an empty vector. And now A is something completely new. So those are some of the basic operations that you can do with a vector. And just for giggles, let's see what A squared is when I use the dot term element by element exponentiation there. So there you have it. And we'll make a new one here in a second.